Hello everyone, welcome back to another Europa Universalis 4 video. We are stuck in a coalition war that just started at the end of last episode. So we have Poland, Lithuania, and France on our side. We're fighting Austria, Hungary, Milan, the Pope, and the Mamluks. Mamluks are the biggest threat. So one thing I do want to do is take out a loan and build a fort there and there so we can control the passageways into Anatolia. Okay, we stack quite their army. And you go there. Spain. Okay, so Castile either inherited or integrated Aragon. Why is Castile still listed? Oh well, maybe it just didn't update yet. ...246% technology cost, I think it just hasn't updated. Because if they actually do have 246 technology cost, something's wrong. Let's convert Salento and Bari. Let's send some guys here. And get a admiral. Unfortunately, we lost. We might have to send some guys back over to deal with that. Oh great. Just what I wanted. Negative diplomatic reputation. Luckily, we can get the new military tech. Which is great. Okay, you actually go down there because I don't think there's going to be a threat from there. Oh, cool. We won the siege. And let's build up our navy because we definitely need to get naval supremacy. That will give us a huge advantage in this war. There you go. You should be the one sieging. You just do miscellaneous work. I don't really care if you take over Wallachia. You can have Wallachia, Austria. I don't like taking that much attrition, but I also don't like the Mamluks attacking us, so... let's see... Salerno. We're not going to get them before they get unrest. Or separatism. Oh, well, they don't, apparently. I'm not sure why. Come on, you're losing way too many troops. You go there, then there. Let's always attack. Here we go. Cool, we have won the siege of 4R. Let's more draw army back together then. Maybe not into a stack that big. What do we need to restore the seam system? I don't currently want to restore the Roman Empire yet. I want to restore the seam system. Is that a mission tree now? Yeah, it is. So we need Divwiggy. Why do we need Divwiggy? That's sad. We also need Erzikan and Erzurum. Okay, so we can fight another war as Caraman after this coalition war to take those two last provinces, and then we should be able to restore the seam system soon. And that will give us extra development in Constantinople and a huge bonus to manpower. So then, converting Asia Minor will allow us to restore the Pentarchy. Okay. Okay, that was an easy stack wipe. None of your artillery, none of your artillery. What? You are kidding me. How did you stack wipe 18,000 of my men? I was supposed to get a notification if something like that happens. I just instantly lost like 18,000 men. That's not fun. So once we take this, we can go into Egypt and then start really beating the Mamluks up. How in the world do you stack wipe an army that big when I'm at the same tech level as you? Ugh. Wow. That was quick. Have all those ships go out at once. Go, producing more ships, making sure I don't get stack wiped. Looks like the Mamluks are too afraid to do anything. I need to bring a force to deal with the rebellion in my territory, which I think is going to be this force. Come on, you need to win. Seriously? One of you is probably gonna win before I do. Finally. Let's get our good leader. Let's see if I can catch you. Wow, we are winning by a long shot. You finally have some war exhaustion, so are you willing to make peace? No, not yet. It's sad that Kando is the war leader because we have a huge negative modifier towards him accepting, so we'll basically need to kill every coalition member. Can we not convert Napoli? Oh, we can. No, don't go there yet. I need you for this battle. You will arrive on Thessalius. I actually probably didn't need this many men, but whatever. Well, I am getting terrible wolves, so maybe I did need this many men. Yeah, with my luck, I'll always need this many more men. Poland isn't looking too good. Come on, you have to stop wooling so badly, friend. You can do this. Okay, we didn't wooly stack right, but whatever. Okay, rebels to collab. Not really a problem for me. So, where's the center of the printing press? Well, no. So why does Rome get so much support for it for free out of nowhere? Who knows? Anyway, my fleet is definitely healed by now, so I can go and finally start winning the naval part of this war. The Mamluks immediately flee as they see me coming. Here we go, we won, took a lot of casualties, but we won. Come on, you can do that all. Stop walling ones. It's like every time they wall an 8 and I wall a 1, or I wall a 1 and they wall an 8. Nothing in between. Here we go, now we both got 1s. And I'm losing, so that isn't good. How is 28,000 men not enough to siege this? Hey. Not nice, Austria. Not nice. actually didn't lose too much in that battle. Let's leave a solid number of galleys out here. And let's leave a solid number of galleys out here. The west below right here. Wow, you are still nowhere near demand, accepting my very reasonable demands. Well, this time if I get stack wiped, it's not my own troops, so let's hope we don't get stack wiped though anyway. Can you win, though? Oh, you probably can. It's really sad I can't set but Beast and Mamluks. It would be nice if I could. Then I could take all their money and stuff. I lose 10 times as many men. That's just dumb. When I get, like, about equal walls as about equal tech. I still want an X candle. Oh, we finally won that siege. This is what I want minimum in a peace deal. Then I can declare war on Caroman, and this can all work out. Hopefully they don't win the siege that they're doing at like the last minute or something. That would be stupid. Oh, and of course peasants attack me. Why does rebels have to attack me and not Austria? Yeah, it would be really nice if anyone but Candle could have been the world leader for this. What union was this again? I forget. Probably not important. Now we could ask, like, just leave them with one province and then ask for land in Italy instead. No, we can't do that. I don't feel like leaving them with one province. I already have enough border war. We're gonna fight for clean borders. That's like the noblest thing we can possibly fight for, white. Let's actually get some more men. You don't need to be there. Oh, you're not important enough. You get out of there. Yep, you get insta-killed. As expected. Let's hope we can leave the fort in time. He's a decent general. How do you have 115% discipline? That is insane. You should not have 115% discipline. You are not the Ottomans. I think the Mamluks think they are the Ottomans now. You have religious zeal. And you are a religious centaur. So I think we're about as close as we can get in Italy. So now let's start in Anatolia. Wow, this episode has gone on way too long. But let's end the war. We will win this war, no matter what the cost. go and do that so we can finally get a fort in Anatolia and people can stop just waltzing in whenever they want to. Like the Pope is. We need to build a wall. Why does Venice keep on sallying out its navy? I have to be inflicting some casualties. Why do you cause so much damage? How can you cause so much damage? Oh, and now the Hungarian Navy is coming. They're stacked right. Close enough. The Mamluks are getting most of their forts back. Why? Why are you going out of Ibiza? They just can't make any progress over there. Oh, they just made quite a bit of progress, never mind. Well, infantry reduction cost. Cool. Not again, Austria. We're just killing cold little one stacks. This is gonna take forever if we want Kandar's. Yeah, let's just have them break treaties. And then let's occupy that, and then we can just kill off the Kandar later. Come on. Don't roll that terribly. You need to win. Need to get, like, a stack of 2 units on those provinces. Well, join them into suicide missions then, I guess. Come on. No, you can't just keep on walking further and further away. That's not how this works. Mork army. Don't have enough money. Loan! Mork army. There. Like, all Austria ever does is kill my one unit stack. Well, at least I finally have a 4. Come on, stop rolling so badly. How are you already at negative 14? How are you already at 7? Rebels are killing all our progress. This war started 5 years ago, and it feels like 50. Of course you're gonna kill my one-stack army again, Austria, that's all you ever do. If you're gonna attack my navies again, Venice, because that's all you ever do. Can we actually kill this army? Yeah, we stack wiped and lost the siege. And we lost another siege. Just gonna keep on coming at me on my mountain tile? I mean, okay. Here you go. All I need is to occupy these two tiles. Ignore the dozens of sieges we're losing. Can we make peace? What? I don't want military access. No, we can't, but I don't think we're ever gonna get that. We're letting them get off way too lightly, but I mean... Oh well. I so wish we could do separate peace. This war would be so much easier that way. Wow. That was exactly almost 200,000 casualties on each side. Look at my name. It's huge. And we spent a whole hour on one episode. Build buildings. Gain 50 administrative power. Byzantium gets building spree for 25 years, giving the following effects. Tax income plus 10 ducats. Oh, I'm glad we built some buildings during all of that. Anyway, I guess that's gonna be the end of the episode. Wow, that was a hard war. Yeah. At least, though, we actually have the provinces we need to now, get the achievement. Or not the achievement, but the decision. And we should be able to do that soon. We only need 3 more provinces, right? Yeah, those 3 provinces. One of which is owned by Candor, who we should be able to eat up in 12 years. One of which is owned by this guy, who we should be able to eat up in 3 years. Wonderful. That's it for the video. Congratulations if you actually get that this far. I don't know if anyone will. But wow, this was a really, really long war. Yeah. Bye. See you in the next episode.